Hey there everyone, this is Sagar from Department of Communication and Journalism, University of Mumbai, and we finally have a name for our podcast. It's called the Random Podcasters, if I am not getting the name wrong. I think it's something what me and Jagruti last time decided to give this particular podcast a name. And today what we'll be doing is we'll be discussing something called as nostalgia. So Jagruti, just introduce me to the topic.
So today we're going to talk about, shows, films and books that we used to like in childhood, and now how do we look at that?
Okay, and I've got some pretty good guests. I've got Anamika Dutta, who is a student at the MSCJ department. And we have their head of department with us, Sanjay Ranade sir. And this is the first time that I guess he'll be on that podcast stage. Let us see how much we can get out of Sanjay Ranade this time around. So let us start with the senior most person. Sanjay sir, how do you see media in childhood?
Media in childhood was a desperate visual treat which I never got.
Okay.
So you could look at Amar Chitrakatha in the stalls, but we never had the money to buy it. And then I found an uncle, not an uncle, kind of friend of a friend of a friend's relative's uncle kind of thing, who worked in the Times of India. He was in the circulation section. They used to live in Kolhapur.
Okay.
And they used to have Indrajal comics, because Times of India at that time used to produce Indrajal comics. So my first consumption of comics was Indrajal comics. So it was Phantom and then Mandrake and Lothar. Then it gradually went up to, kind of things which came with the Indian versions of all this, so Bahadur and those characters, and then
Fallout Singh.
Inspector Vikram.
Yes.
So that was my consumption of magazines, but I always loved cinema because we used to live in Navy Nagar in Kolhapur, and every Saturday, I think, or every Sunday. We used to take the chatai and the tiffin box in the night and go into the open lawn, and we used to watch cinema from both sides of the screen.
Something like Swadesh, right?
Wow.
So we would watch that, and the film that is kind of etched into my head is Kattipathar.
Wow.
So when he turns around, maine tere liye, and then he turns around on the chair to look at the audience, that shot is stuck in my head. Anytime you tell me, I can describe the shot. It's like stuck there.
Isn't it amazing? What memories do you have, Anamika?
Actually, my story is a little interesting because when I was young, when I was a child, I was quite an introvert. I mean, I still am, I think, to a certain extent. For me, I didn't have any friends.
Okay.
None whatsoever. So for me, I used to just stay back home and watch a lot of cartoons. I still remember Pokemon and Beyblade and all that. And for me, I used to read a lot of books. Not just books, magazines.
And this
sort of
was
things.
In the year?
1996, 97, 98. Back when Pokemon had not come, but I had Dexter, Powerpuff Girls, and like Cartoon Network all day. That was my everything, basically. I never got out and I played with other kids or anyone. Just back home and watching cartoons, that's all. That's something that I...
Any particular fond memory that you have?
A lot of memories. I remember crying with the characters.
Ooh.
A lot. Even the first episode of Pokemon, when they go off the journey, Ash and Pikachu, and Pikachu gets hurt by the Pidgeys and all that. And I started crying because I thought they were my friends, because I didn't have any other person to connect with. I really connected with the characters. I connected with his journey and how they were, friends together forever. And I used to cry a lot with the characters. A lot of characters.
This is what being introvert does to you.
Yeah.
How about you, Jagruti? You tell me.
You can imagine it's a different tale altogether here. When it comes to magazines and all, I think garmi ki chutiyon mein nani ke ghar jaane ke time pe jo train mein we buy Champak, and mummy used to get Grahalakshmi and Grahashobha. Wo bahut interesting hota tha. Chacha Chaudhary ka comics I used to love. Champak was definitely, and the Hindi version. English was not something I liked at all. Here, Hindi one was amazing. Usme animals ko personify karke, matlab those were really good stories. And also, I used to be really intrigued by ki, you know, Grah Shobha, Grah Lakshmi mein kya hai. I mean, that was something really. I want to know what, you know, adults read. I guess that was one thing.
Amazing. So it turns out it's not so different at all, despite we being from certain states. I simply remember my years of me growing up. I started off with Chacha Chaudhary, which was for me at that time, names like Diamond Comics and Pran were so synonymous that we used to have something like Billu as well. Then we used to have, you know, Chatur Chachi, if I'm not mistaken, you know. All these characters were so Indianized to an extent because during my time in Aurangabad, I never had the opportunity to read, you know, comics which were, say, something like the Spider-Mans and the He-Mans were not easily available. So we had to go almost like 10 kilometers to Aurangabad station. You had to get a magazine over there and come back. Although I do remember my years of growing up, and if you are talking about media nostalgia, it has to be Doordarshan. For me, I think I'm the last kind of people who was looking at Doordarshan in a way. And for me, I was just 4 or 5 years old. So every morning waking up, you know, you're sitting on a sitting, you know, with that peace of mind on a Sunday morning at 9 o'clock, and you see He-Man on television. That was something way different for me at that time because I never had the opportunity to, you know, be a part of the experience like Star Wars, and I never heard of it till the time I came to Mumbai. But till that point of time, He-Man was something which filled me with those, you know, my particular memories are like looking back at cartoons like DuckTales. So, you know, looking back at cartoons like Popeye, which were in Hindi at that point of time. For me, to take a look at American characters in Hindi was something really extraordinary because I could never imagine myself looking at movies today the same way. However, those particular characters intrigued me. So, tell me one thing.
I agree on that Hindi aspect. I think I really loved Pogo for that matter because they were providing good, really interesting content in Hindi. Because English was not really something I was comfortable with. As a child, at least.
Also, another factor matters. I am a Bengali. I grew up in West Bengal. I learned Hindi just from watching those shows, those cartoons.
Cartoons.
I learned a whole new language. Although I'm not very good at it, but I still understand. I can speak it.
So. Tell me one thing. Say something like when Cartoon Network transitioned into say something like various languages. Didn't you take a look at that particular cartoon in say Bengali and could relate to?
No, not really. I enjoyed it in English and Hindi. We had two options, either to listen to it in the English audio or the Hindi audio. I thought the Hindi audio was more like, you know, that brought the characters out, that actually made them more appealing to me. I thought the Bengali would just ruin the whole scene because they would not talk in Bengali. I mean, like, they're going on a journey with Pokemon and stuff. Why would they speak Bengali?
Kotha kya
That's weird, I thought.
Sanjay sir, how did that transition for you happen from say magazines, say newspapers to say something like television? What are your earliest memories of television? So what happened when you actually had a television set? I know you have some great stories.
Yeah, definitely.
I think I belong to a very lucky generation of people because we evolved with the medium. So we know, we came with black and white newspapers, then we saw color newspapers, we saw magazines coming. Then we saw the evolution of TV, the evolution of cinema, the evolution of all media, you know, so typewriter to computer. So we are very lucky in that sense, very lucky. So I remember that every Saturday in the night, we used to have, Doordarshan used to have black and white films. And they used to have a festival.
Okay.
So all week there will be films by Raj Kapoor. All week there will be films by Guru Dutt. So I have seen these films in the neighbor's house.
Right.
So I remember Clive Lloyd's first double century in Wankhede. We had to walk all the way to another building where there was this family, Sharma family, and that woman was very, you know, kind of vibrant kind of woman. So we used to be about 30-40 people. They had the black and white TV. And they had something called an inverter, which we didn't know what this was. Now we use it randomly. But they had this very fascinating gadget by which the electricity could be kept going, so we could watch the match. And I know watching Clive Lloyd there scoring his 200 runs while that Sharma aunty was giving us aloo paratha and chutney and pudine ki chutney and all that. So when finally one day matches came, right, I know that as college students, by the time I was in college, so we used to watch in our friend's house, the mother and father used to go away. Beer was a big thing. So we used to have this eating, drinking and watching one day matches. And it was a fascinating thing to watch one day matches in the day happening in South Africa in the evening. So it was very fascinating that how come they have got evening and this afternoon. So yes, you study geography and you are told sun rises here, revolution. But when you see it live happening, they are playing cricket in the night and I am watching it in the day when my evening has not even come. So it was like, wow, it was big, you know, big thing. So I'm very lucky because I could watch that transition from you know, black and white TV to color TV. The first time I remember Asian Games came and there was color TV. The neighbor had the TV, color TV, EC TV. And the, you know, I don't know how it is for you people, but on television when you watch a deep sea jumper, you know, making all those funny things on the top of the ramp, and then he or she jumps off and dives into that thing with that flips, and it was absolutely fascinating because the pool which we had seen, I stayed in Ghatkopar, there was this pool at Odeon, so only BMC had swimming pools. So pool that we had seen was that if you kick, you're going to hit someone. So that's the swimming pool. And here there was this pool where this man jumped from such a huge height and went so deep and came out. It was fascinating to just watch that, okay, there are swimming pools like that. Swimming pools are like that. You can't imagine swimming pools like that.
I think our generation usually, it's your generation maybe, I think we just took it for granted. The, later on, I guess I remember sports in my time. I don't really recall the 87 World Cup, maybe. I simply do recall the 1992 World Cup. I think that was a time when they were wearing the color jerseys for the first time. And I guess that was very fascinating because till all this point of time, for me, watching a cricket match was a complete pain because I couldn't understand who was playing what. Unless, and not being racist, unless the person was black or he was absolutely white, we couldn't figure it out. For me, in my case, color television came exactly during 1992. So that was a good time for me because I could get to see all these things in color. And what makes it more special is my nostalgia usually generally builds up with, you know, all these sports channels and everything else because that's how, you know, I simply connected myself with television apart from anything else.
This color thing, you know, my mother rejected one day.
Okay.
Because she found the colors disorienting.
Oh, okay.
Wow. Okay. So, she, according to her, on the black and white screen, men and women wearing white clothes was more discernible than men and women wearing colored clothes on a color TV. She said, confuse her. I can't make out. I thought color would be the easiest to figure out. That this is not your team, that's your team. She said, no, it was easier in the black and white. So,
it's something
that actually is very interesting.
I think it's interesting because this takes us back to the time of, you know, when we are understanding cinema. From 1928 to 32 was the year of the transition. So I guess it makes it more interesting because by that time sound had come about, and that's where most of the people weren't ready to accept sound.
It might have been disorienting for them.
It was quite disorienting for them. I think the chaplains and all those people. I think media has a certain way of getting around with, you know, and it's so amazing that everyone has their own story to tell.
Even subtitles came in like that. No, it was slightly very weird to read in the starting, and now we need them.
Subtitles came in as part of an experiment. That it is easier to teach the Hindi language in rural India through Hindi cinema music than it is through classrooms. So this was an experiment that was conducted in the program called Chhaya Geet. And Chhaya Geet used to have, Chhaya Geet was a weekly program where it was a roundup. And then there used to be an anchor who would say that in this week we are going to look at songs to deal with human relations or love or something like that. And then all the songs would be like that. And that is when in television, with the song, you began to have subtitles.
But colored ones,
because,
right?
Yeah, colored. Yeah. Yellow. Yellow. The color
so
of the subtitles.
So,
jo
bolenge wo actually it color mein aayega.
It will come in yellow color.
Yeah.
And it was, the experiment was actually successful. Yeah, the people definitely learned the Hindi language through Hindi film song because they knew the song by heart. They knew it.
Right.
So it was just a question of finding that song in the symbols of the alphabet. So once they connected that, they could easily read. Because the song already played in their head. They already knew the song.
For me,
That's a research.
For me, it was very weird because during my time, I do remember in Aurangabad when those people came in to install the cable for the first time, the basic premise was we have to pay 25 rupees and they'll be giving us two channels extra. For my mother to convince my father that this was a good thing, she explained the same thing to my father in the same linear format as the cable wala had actually explained it to her. My father at that time wanted those two extra channels. I don't know for what reason. He wanted those two channels because he wanted his son to speak English. In my house, cable TV was bought in so that I was the first child to go into an English medium school. And they felt by watching television, because I think now looking back at those times, they really felt that they would have had limited help for me in case of, say, English. At that point of time, my father always stressed on the fact that English channels ghar mein hona zaruri hai because the kid is going to an English school. And which was very weird for me because at that point of time during 92-93, I got exposed to so many amount of things. I cannot really begin to tell you. The biggest problem though was, although my father bought it for that particular reason, I couldn't understand the accent.
Yeah.
I couldn't understand the accent. I think today, even when I watch something online, I really need those subtitles because I really like to read a story instead of that. I think those subtitles things help me out a lot because going to a theater and watching a movie like Inception, once you don't understand Inception or you miss out a part, you're just confused with what really was she asking or what really was he saying. I think that really broke it up for me. Subtitles made it much more easier to connect to a story rather than anything else. When it comes down to today's times, we are seeing this entire thing of digital media and this digital exposure now. Maybe it's taking away from what we have in what we had in our nostalgia years. Simply because what we experience with television, maybe the next generation might not do that. They already have a second screen with them. Today, if you have to compare, Anamika, here's my question to you. If you have to compare the nostalgia of today of yesteryears to a digital era of today, how would you define it?
I think it's absolutely different because I also remember I used to watch Malguri Days and all that. I think that essence is completely different. The whole aesthetics of that show is completely different. Now we have web series and everything where there is no, everything is shot from someone's perspective. It's not really that, it does not bring out the same essence as it used to back in the day. So I think it's very different. People have a very narrow perspective towards friends, content.
Okay, Jagruti, you tell me, what's your view?
For me, the whole concept of entertainment has changed a bit. For at that point of time, anything and everything that was available was nice. You know, if I'm tuning into Povo, I'll watch it for like 2 hours and I'll just watch. Right now, I constantly keep changing. I mean, even if I'm watching something on YouTube, I constantly, if I don't like it in half, I just change it. And that kind of a thing is just there. And that is something I'm dealing with. And it's not grabbing my attention the way things did in the past because there are too many options and I have the option of switching out very easily.
Okay, Sanjay sir, you have seen the complete evolution of media amongst us. So in that particular case, how do you see nostalgia of the yesteryears being challenged by the new media of today and the future?
Just to go through it, the first English film that I saw was African Safari.
That old.
Now that was in the Colaba Navy quarters. So I was on the ground and there was. The first English film I saw in the theater was Star Wars.
You stole my dream.
Instant connection.
And I saw that film in Sterling Theater. I was sitting in the first seat. Because paisa nahi. So I was sitting in the first seat and I still remember that, you know, the thing comes like this. and the commentary begins somewhere in the galaxy.
And
I kept looking at the ceiling because I felt, I mean, how far is it going to go? It kept going up, and I had no experience of watching cinema in a theater. Then recently that new film came at the 7th or the 8th one.
Okay. The 8th one. A New Hope.
So I saw that in Max.
Okay.
And then I thought, okay, now I need to look at this carefully. So I saw the entire Star Wars thing on the laptop. Okay. And I realized that the connection to the first one stays.
Yeah.
All the rest are simply disappeared. They don't matter. They are so completely irrelevant to me. I don't connect with them at all.
Because that made an impact.
Because it just, it was my first experience. So
first
it stays.
Are always
see,
special.
The Star Wars, you know, the whole thing coming out of the screen like this, you know, throughout and those big ships and all that. Now when I watch the entire thing, I'm looking at narrative, I'm looking at content, I'm looking at meaning, I'm looking at all kinds of things. And I find that that, you require, you know, with media, one of the things I find is that you do require some degree of, a very high degree of innocence. People are constantly criticizing the mass media, but it requires a bit of an innocence to be able to just deal with the content. I mean, it's fine. It doesn't necessarily have to be taking you to Nirvana or something every time. Just deal with it. It's fine. Relax. But people are getting very peculiar. They are not sitting with the content.
There's this fact about I am paying money, so I want something good out of it in terms of, because I have so much to choose and I am choosing you, so.
Yeah, it is in economics you are talking of the opportunity cost. It has gone up very high.
Okay.
See, if I were not been watching the film, what would I have been doing? I would have been sitting at home.
Yeah.
But if you were not watching this film, you would have been here, you would have been there, you would have been here, you would
exactly
have been there.
Right.
So among all these, your opportunity cost is very high. My opportunity cost was nothing. I would be sitting at home. So, you know, we from Ghatkopar, I'll tell you how we went, so you can imagine. From Ghatkopar, we first went to Vikhroli. Okay, now you can imagine Ghatkopar and Vikhroli now is one station. We walked from Ghatkopar to Vikhroli. Why did we go to Vikhroli? Because in Vikhroli depot, there was seven limited bus. Limited bus was a two-decker bus.
Okay,
so from Vikhroli depot, right at the front seat, because we got into depot, we went to VT. Then we got down at Stirling. So you can imagine how much time this must have taken. Then we went to Stirling, we took the tickets. We had that uncle who took us, okay, his son and two or three of us, had only so much money that he took two moongfali, the groundnut cup packet, which we had to share, about five or six of us. And that's all we had, because we came out from there, we waited for the bus, we got into the double decker again, we travelled all the way to Vikhroli and walked back.
I think the most amazing thing is that you still remember all of it. Like not
Because all of this, if I were not been doing that, what I've been doing? Sitting at home.
Yeah, exactly. That is why you actually...
There is no option. What would I have been doing?
Have that feeling.
But for these people today,
they
were not been doing this, they were doing this, that, there were so many options. So the opportunity cost has gone up.
True.
Has easy access in the media, you know, within the media industry, has led to the downfall or, you know, nostalgia being killed in that particular way? Do you think so? Because, see, you used to watch Star Wars. I do remember your generation's consumption of media. You still can name me the day, time and place when you watched Amitabh Bachchan movies, the way you waited in queues. Today, maybe my generation or generation, you know, 10 years younger to me or 20 years younger to me, don't really require that kind of things, because we really, maybe I would understand because I'd been to a theater single screen in my early days of my life, and I do understand the pain that follows if you don't get a ticket. I think with this rise of digital media, I think we are slowly, are we slowly killing nostalgia, or is nostalgia, there's no certain term like nostalgia that exists in media.
Nostalgia will give, it's a human thing. But what has actually happened is, from being completely passive viewers, you all become completely active viewers. There is a very high degree of determinism from your side. From our side, there is no degree of determinism. I could not watch Shole when it came. I didn't have the money. So what did we do? We went to the local panwala and we heard the dialogues on the cassette. So the local panwala's big draw was, he has the Shole dialogues. And he has one side Sholay dialogue, other side Diwar dialogue.
Wow.
So the Pangwala started standing there. The Paan is over, the cigarette is over, the talk is over, but we are listening to the dialogue.
Right.
So we grew up listening because we didn't have the money. I have not seen Diwar. I saw Diwar only after I grew up. I did not see Diwar. I did not see Sholay in Minerva, 70 ml. I did not see it because I was running out of the money.
All your nostalgia is more about the media coming up. I think if I were to look at nostalgia of watching anything outside, it would be more like who I went with and if that person matters to me. That kind of a human emotion wala factor comes more, and that is how I remember.
Because you have we didn't have exactly. A uncle is going.
Yeah.
So if father is sending, uncle is going. Therefore,
yeah.
I see the film.
Yeah. So otherwise, it's not really about the person or any other thing.
It is not that you know this person is passionate about cinema. They may be passionate, but nobody has the money.
Right.
So no, there was no question of doing that. See, so you know, for us, for instance, BBC for us was when I even now when I think of BBC, I remember Natkarni because he was the man who would scream from that flat. That, you know, have you heard of the BBC? Because he was the only guy who had this shortwave radio where he could hear the BBC. We didn't have it. So there was no question to listen to BBC. But that man used to listen to the BBC. So I remember that when Indira Gandhi was killed, Natkarni came running and telling us, Indira Gandhi is killed. Okay, so, and I was
in that possible in today's
time? I was in journalism at that time. So for us, it was like, oh, really? Okay, so then call up the office. So, and by, see, you have to understand, by the time Indira Gandhi was killed, we were at one level. When Rajiv Gandhi was killed, we were at a different level. I went and told Natkarni, Rajiv Gandhi is dead.
Such a beautiful change.
So, we changed in very interesting ways. So, for instance, assassinations have always been very fascinating to everybody. It's a sad thing. But if you look at reporting or journalists, I mean, it is morbid to say that, but journalists love death.
Yeah.
Got a story.
Definitely.
So assassinations are fascinating things.
Yeah.
You know, so I remember the killing of Saddam Hussein. I remember, I see the visual, like I know how he was cold held by his beard, taken out.
Yeah.
And how the Americans, you know, fooled around, literally fooled around with the
body.
Sentiments of that community, and then they got back. So I think it was interesting. Those visuals were quite fascinating. So yeah, I mean, it is going to be that way.
I think one of the other things that I guess that changed along with time were the special effects that were being used in your media and how they played along with those things. Now, we all know, we have discussed about it quite a long back regarding how visuals were being used. Any peculiar visuals that you quite remember?
I think the one thing is, pehle we used to just take in whatever we got. Now we question everything a lot. You know, मतलब मेरे को नहीं मालूम है VFX के बारे में कुछ भी, पर फिर भी वो अच्छा नहीं है, मैं ऐसा opinion आता है. पहले नहीं था ये सब चीजों के बारे में. You know, if I look at Aryaman also, I kind of like, you know, उस time का it was amazing.
You'll never get over
Aryaman. No, never. So that is one thing. It's just there.
So okay, so we move on into our final segment. What is your view about your particular era, your particular nostalgic memories and the media? Sum up in 30 seconds, each and every one of you. I'll start with Anamika.
I will always say it was better, 90s kids. Everything was so much better. I think these days, so much of content you have to choose and you sometimes end up not choosing the right thing and you regret it and then you have a lot of questions. Back then, we got the best of everything, I feel. Because we still had that space to play with human emotions. I think every genre has been done, every kind of category has been done. Now they are being just overdone. So I find back in the days that was so much better. Content was better.
Sanjay sir, in 30 seconds.
Not nostalgia, because I'm not a nostalgic person. So and when I studied psychology, I realized it's a kind of illness, so I stopped doing it.
Oh boy, we are all ill. You should have mentioned that before the podcast.
I think that what is happening for me is that this whole long journey, it comes back to me. So, you know, like when I listen to Boney M, I know that Boney M's song, and ABBA, right? ABBA and Boney M were the first time that color television in India celebrated 31st December. And the combination was Boney M, ABBA, and Gulam Ali.
Oh, okay.
Interesting.
Live for Doordarshan. Wow. And he sang Hangama Hai Kyun Barpa and Chupke Chupke Raate.
Oh, okay. Jagruti, you ended 30 seconds.
I really like, I think it's a very exciting time to be where we are right now. There's so many things that are happening, so there's a lot of options. I do want to get over the fact that I have too much to choose from, and if I'm making the right decision or not, that's definitely a struggle that I have, but I still like the fact that I have options to choose from.
Ooh. With that being said, thank you for listening to the Random Podcasters. Next time, when we meet, we shall be getting more people, more audiences. And this time, stay tuned, because this particular, the next episode will be particularly for those Harry Potter fans. So, with that being said, thank you and have a great day. I hope I screwed up the last particular line. Thank you and have a great day. Thank you so much.